Since 2007, Ubisoft have been building the Assassin's Creed franchise. One of the coolest things in many of these games is the way they show us a different version of history. They use real historical figures and mostly stick to the real dates of their death. Our teachers might tell us that people from history died in natural causes or strange illness, but Ubisoft and Assassin's Creed showed us that history was often much more violent. As they say, history is written by winners. But if we believe Ezio, Altair and others, it's actually written by the assassins. The first one, Blackbeard. History says. Interestingly, there are still many unaware questions about Thatch life. Some even argued that his real name might be Edward Thatch.
Potion's nothing without charisma. If a man plays the fool, then it's only fools he'll persuade, but appear to be the devil.
Historians have used nearly 10 different names to refer to him. Despite the mysteries surrounding the identity, the legacy of Blackbeard remains unmatched. It is believed that Blackbeard was born into a well-off family in Bristol, England. After the treaty that ended Queen Anne's War, Blackbeard find himself as a sailor without a purpose. Instead going back home, he joined the forces with Captain Benjamin Hornigold and was given his own slot to command. We see the first documents mentioned of Blackbeard emerging from under Hornigold's wing and leading his own crew. Blackbeard crossed path with Steve Bonnet, an educated man from wealthy background who turned to piracy. Bonnet's crew was getting really unhappy and they were about to start a mutiny, which means they want to take over the ship and go against their captain. So, to stop any fighting and disagreements, Blackbeard stepped in and became the new captain of Bonnet's ship. He did this to make sure everyone was safe and to keep things under control. Just 1 year after becoming famous, Blackbeard was chased by a guy named Robert Minard and caught near Arkroket Island. His ship had only 20 men on board because the others were either on the land or kicked out by Blackbeard himself. They had a big fight and Minard tricked Blackbeard by hiding the most of his men below deck, making it seem like he had only small crew.
I know you're coming to call me home, Kenway. Your faith in me is kind. But with Nassau done in, I feel I'm finished.
When Blackbeard boarded, Minard's men surprised the pirates in ambush. During the fight, Blackbeard broke Minard's sword, but he was eventually surrounded. He tried to attack Minard once more, only to be cut down by the men surrounding him. After the encounter, Blackbeard's body showed 5 bullet wounds and more than 20 sword cuts. Assassins says, Blackbeard was like super tough and cool guy. He had shipped called Queen Anne's Revenge. On his ship, he meets a guy named Stead Bonnet, and since Stead is new to being a pirate, Blackbeard called him Nightshift. Blackbeard also meets Edward Kenway, and they become friends. He introduced Edward to other pirates, like Benjamin Hornigold, who all wants to make Nassau a perfect place for pirates to live. Despite confessing his intentions to retire, Blackbeard accepts a pardon in North Carolina. However, he soon realizes that he needs more money to enjoy a peaceful life in retirement. The only logical way for him to achieve that is to come out of retirement and continue his violent and piracy life. While Ubisoft is known for tweaking history in their games, they introduce Robert Minard as the main commissioner to hunt down Blackbeard. The final battle between Blackbeard and Minard unfolds quite similarly to first-hand accounts. It also says that Minard took Blackbeard's head to claim the reward, and legend has it that after the headless body was tossed into the ocean, it miraculously swam around the ship 20 times. Israel Putnam. History says, the real impact he made on history was during the American Revolution. Unfortunately, Putnam wasn't good at planning or leading in battles, so George Washington didn't give him important tasks. It's like he was clumsy major general, always getting into some funny troubles. He lost the key battles and fell out of favor with Washington. In 1779, he had a stroke that left him paralyzed, and he had to stop serving in military. 11 years later, in 1790, Putnam passed away and was buried in Connecticut. But later, they moved his remains to a different monument, because people keep stealing pieces of his tomb as a souvenirs. Assassins says, Putnam's encounter with Connor in Assassin's Creed 3 happened during the Battle of Bunker Hill. He teamed up with Connor to take down a Templar. Putnam devised a plan to have Connor sabotage the Redcoat frigate surrounding the British Navy, which boosted the morale of his troops for the upcoming battle. However, things didn't go as planned, and Putnam's forces were overwhelmed due to being outnumbered, forcing him to retreat. Despite his step back, Putnam later returned the favor to Connor by speaking highly of him and declaring him as a hero for the Patriots. Ubisoft made sure to portray Putnam as a person who acknowledged his mistakes, requesting to be reassigned to recruitment duties after his failure at Fort Clinton, Montgomery, and the Battle of Long Island. This made him look dignified and self-aware.
I send you, my best man, to complete a mission more important than any that has come before. And you return to me with nothing but apologies and excuses.
Rashid ad-Din Sinan. History says, Sinan's story shrouded in mysteries, and only bits of it had survived through times. We do not know that he was in charge of Messiah and the lead of religious group during the Crusades against King Richard I. He had to deal with the invading forces and also had conflict with Sultan Saladin. Sinan even tried to assassinate Saladin several times, but those attempts didn't work. During the siege of Masyaf, something unexpected happened. Saladin's force were about to attack, but the siege was stopped when they found a plate of hot scones next to Saladin's bed. These scones were shaped like the emblem of the Order of Assassins, and there was a note with a poison dagger saying Saladin should live. Surprisingly, Saladin believed Sinan himself had sent the scones. After this, Saladin and Sinan formed as aliens. Some stories says Sinan had special powers, maybe even being divine, but he passed away in 1192 at Alcaf Castle in Masyaf. The idea that someone could use baking goods to cause fear might make people think he had divine abilities. Assassin says, Sinan, also known as Al-Mu'allim, which means the mentor, is Altair's teacher and guide. During the siege of Masyaf, Al-Mu'allim tells Altair to set a trap that takes out many Templars and ends their siege. The trap used huge, crushing logs and is way more impressive than just making scones. As the story unfolds, Al-Mu'allim ordered Altair to assassinate several Templars, saying it's to weaken their groups. But later, Altair finds out that Al-Mu'allim set up these killings to gain power among the Templars. When Altair confronted him, Al-Mu'allim shares the assassin's mantra, nothing is true, everything is permitted. This saying becomes important in the later games of Assassin's Creed. Even though Altair and Al-Mu'allim were once close, Altair ends up defeating his former mentor despite the assassin beliefs of sparing lives when not necessary. Altair ends up burning Al-Mu'allim on the pyre.
May the Father of Understanding guide you.
May the Father of Understanding guide you.
Rodrigo Borgia. History says, Pope Alexander VI was a very controversial pope in history because he liked women, even though the church says its leaders should be celibate. Originally named Rodrigo Borgia, he became a deacon in the church in 4056 when his uncle became a Pope Calixtus III. Alexander VI claimed the ranks and became a cardinal bishop in 1471. He got rich and powerful by being associated with five different popes. During his time as a pope, Alexander VI had many children with different women. Some were born within marriage, some were not. In 1492, he controversially became pope throughout political tricks. There were rumors that other future popes, Giovanni di Lorenzo, worried about Alexander VI's power and called him rapacious wolf. But some people doubt this. While there is no definite proof that Pope Alexander VI poisoned, murdered, or chased people for money or power, he did give important roles in the church to his family members. One mysterious incident involved Alexander VI and his son Caesar Borgia failing sick after a dinner with Cardinal Adriano de Carneto. Caesar got better, but Pope couldn't recover. Assassins says, in Assassin's Creed 2 and Brotherhood, Pope Alexander VI, known as Rodrigo Borgia, is portrayed as a murderer and ruthless individual. As a member of Templar Order, he attains the rank of Grand Master in 4076, before becoming a pope. During his departure from Florence, Italy, a group of assassins led by Ezio's father, Giovanni Arditore, ambushed Rodrigo's entourage. Rodrigo managed to escape the encounter, but witnessed one of his escorts revealing a plan to assassinate Lorenzo de' Medici, which eventually succeeded. In reality, de' Medici would have only just been born at that time. It's quite a stretch to call Rodrigo an assassin of babies, but it illustrates his cunning and opportunistic nature. Unfortunately, Giovanni Auditore pursued Rodrigo but was captured and executed for treason thanks to a plan hatched by Rodrigo and his allies. Using his vast wealth and influence, Rodrigo strategically positioned himself as a pope. Not because he genuinely despised the position, but because he believed it would grant his access to a vault beneath the Vatican. He claimed that only he, as the prophet, could open the vault. In the final showdown, Rodrigo combined the Apple of Eden with the papal staff to try access the vault. However, it was revealed that Rodrigo was not the prophet, as he had believed. Ezio Auditore and Rodrigo had a fierce battle, and Ezio defeated him. However, instead of killing Rodrigo, Ezio chose to let him live, because what he had discovered was far more devastating than any punishment Ezio could inflict. Following Rodrigo's downfall, his son Caesar took over. But due to growing overconfident and failing to meet expectations, Rodrigo decides to poison Caesar's apples. When Caesar discovered the plot, he forced Rodrigo to eat his poison apple, leading to Rodrigo's death. However, Caesar himself survived the ordeal.
I will sleep with anyone as long as they agree to be executed in the morning.
Cleopatra. History says, she was the last active pharaoh, which means she was the powerful ruler of Egypt. But her journey to the throne was not an easy one. Cleopatra grew up in a royal family and she ruled alongside with her father and two brothers. However, she was different from other pharaohs because she was smart and cunning. She didn't want to marry her family members, as was the custom in those days. So she decided to rule alone. As Cleopatra became the sole ruler, she faced many challenges. Egypt was land covered by powerful empires, and she knew she needed support to keep her kingdom safe. So she hatched a clever plan and sought the help of Roman General Julius Caesar. After Caesar was assassinated, Cleopatra faced new dangers. Yet she found another powerful Roman ally, Mark Antony. They fell in love and had three children together. However, their love and power couldn't protect them forever. They faced fierce battle against another Roman leader, Octavian. And sadly, they were defeated. In the face of defeat, Cleopatra and Mark Antony choose to end their lives together. The story goes that Cleopatra used a venom snake, called an asp, to take her own life, and it was a tragic end to a powerful and intelligent ruler. But some people wonder if she was forced to take her life or she was poisoned. Throughout history, Cleopatra's life has been subject of fascination and mystery. Her intelligence, beauty, and determination have inspired countless stories and legends, making her a timeless figure of history. Assassin says, Cleopatra did rule Egypt alongside with her father and brothers, but she received assistance from the Templars to secure her sole rule. Mark Antony became her ally, lover, and eventually the father of some of her children. However, after the Battle of Actium, Mark Antony was betrayed by his own soldiers and suffered a defeat. The remaining soldiers abandoned him, and feeling ashamed, he took his own life. Not longer after Antony's death, a renowned assassin named Amenet, historically accurate with the Egyptian goddess of air, infiltrated Cleopatra's palace and used an asp to kill her. That's it for this video, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give the thumbs up, and see you on the next one.